Hello all, Jeff here with a new video back on Forza Motorsport 6, because as of today, August the 16th, if you're an Xbox Gold subscriber, you'll be able to purchase Forza Motorsport 6 for free. So if you haven't got Forza 6 yet, give it a shot, because I feel this is what Forza 5 was trying to be, and if it wasn't for Forza 6, Forza 7 probably, the basis of Forza 7 probably wouldn't be there. So, and not only that, most things work in this game, so let's check it out and let's show you this. One cool thing that was introduced to Forza 6 was the mod cards, so, stuff like your boosts, such as, earn credits for perfect turns, and crew mods as well, like giving you a bit of extra braking, grip or power, depending on what it is, as per car, as per track, as well as some dare mods, say, you must use hood cam, you must have ABS off, etc, etc. Good way to earn some quick credits, or to progress further in your career. Now, the cover car of this game was the 2017 Ford GT, appearing in Forza 6 a good 2 years before people could actually purchase one themselves. But turn 10, they had got a lot of insight into the development of this car, and they've done such a good job with this car, because it feels amazing in Forza 6. Whether it's realistic, well, I don't know. But, and the hero track of Forza 6, well, it was a new track. It's the Rio Street Circuit. Very, very bumpy indeed. It definitely took me a while to get used to the track. So, if you're new to Forza, Rio is a very hard track. That's coming from someone that's played a lot of Forza, just so you guys know. But Forza was a first of many. Forza 6 had many firsts. Although, night racing, first time we saw night racing in Forza Motorsport since Forza Motorsport 1, believe it or not. So it took 10 years to get night racing back into a Forza Motorsport game. As you can see, that's a Lotus E23. Absolute handful of a car. Yeah, it's not that great. And it was also the first Forza Motorsport game to feature rain racing. So, wet weather had never been a thing in Forza Motorsport until Forza 6 came along. And here's a car that you'll dearly miss, the Mercedes-Benz SLR McLaren. I don't know why it's not in the newer games, but anyway. And the puddles are ridiculous in Forza 6. You'll see huge puddles that cover the whole track. There's one right on the apex of a corner, so, it is very tricky trying to negotiate all those puddles. There's another massive one there. As old man, the Mercedes GT just bottles it at Sheen Curve like he's playing Gran Turismo. Anyway, here's the tracks. So I'll pinpoint those that are new to Forza and have returned for Forza 6. So Monza was new to Forza on Forza 6. Same with Brands Hatch. Another new track for Forza Motorsport 6 was Circuit of the Americas, as well as Daytona, Hockenheimring returning, last seen on Forza 4. Homestead Miami was part of the brilliant NASCAR expansion. Lime Rock is another new track that was on Forza 6. And a few of these that have been on Forza for a bit. Prague was new to Forza 5. Rio, the hero track, Forza 6, obviously new. A lot of these American tracks like Road America, Road Atlanta, Sebring, we've seen them before. Sonoma, last seen on Forza 4 as Infineon Raceway, so that's one of two returning tracks to the game. Another one was Virginia International Raceway. Thankfully, it's part of the Porsche expansion, so no need to learn 100 different layouts in multiplayer. And Watkins Glen was another track that was new to Forza, so a lot of variety there. It's just a shame Forza 7 didn't only got one new track for Forza alone. And in terms of level up to, it's very much like a Horizon-style wheel spin. So, you have these, prize spins, and there you go, I earned 1 million credits. Sometimes you can earn cars out of that. Now, Lexus and Toyota, well, this was the last Forza Motorsport game to feature those makes in the game. So here's the Lexuses. So, all the good stuff's there, including the SC300, which is nice. And the Toyotas, well, there were a heap of race cars that I thought were going to be on Forza 7. Also, we do have the Camry NASCAR stock car in Forza 7, but stuff like the Toyota TSO40, which is DLC in Forza 6, didn't appear on Forza 7. I don't know why, since it was a race car. Same of the Rebellion, same of the Avensis touring cars, they weren't there either. And as well as the Toyota GD1, that, you know, just though, when they said Toyota weren't going to be a part of Forza 7, they did say that you were still going to get race cars, but none of these except the Camrys, which was very weird. But the road cars, yep, for those who love Toyota, dearly missed, especially the AE86. Now, the Corolla is paid DLC, so is the Rebellion, and so is the TSO40, just so you guys know. So the AE86 is in the game, so if you want to deliver some tofu, an initial D style, well, you can in Forza 6. Highly recommend doing a few upgrades though, because it in bone stock, it doesn't have that much power. You really have to throw it in there to get a really good drift like that. But you know, it's a bit of fun. It's good to have these cars again. Just give them a go. But yeah, some of the other cars that aren't in Forza anymore. There's a few. There's the Ultimate GTR, obviously in the newer games. We have the even more mental Ultima 1020. We also have the Tesla. Not seen in newer games, maybe, perhaps so Elon Musk can save enough money to get one of his cars to the moon. Well, good luck with that. And then we have this abomination of a vehicle, the Pontiac Aztec. Luckily, it's paid DLC, so if you don't want the car, you don't have to pay the money for it. The only reason why I think it's in the game is because of Breaking Bad, but the Odyssey in Forza 7 is a lot better than that. Than this, and that's saying something. Well, me being Australian, I want to, you may be wondering, what are the Aussie cars? So we got two Ford Falcon V8 supercars. We have the Mark Winterbottom Pepsi Max crew car, as well as the Marcus Ambrose Xbox Falcon. Both are in Forza 7, and there's only one road going Aussie Ford in this game, and that is the XB Falcon GT. The XY Phase 3 GTHO was a unicorn car on Forza 6 for about 1 week, like 2 years ago. Unfortunately, unobtainable anymore. Anyway, let's check out the others. So for Holden, you had four Commodore V8 supercars. You had the Fabian Coulthard number 14, the James Courtney number 22, the 2015 version. We also had the Jamie Wincup Red Bull Commodore, which for some reason didn't make it to Forza 7. And we also had the Shane Van Gisbergen number 97. Now, in the base game, that's it. But there are a bunch of road-going Hollands that are available as paid DLC until September 15, when the DLC reaches end-of-life status. So we have the VL Commodore Group ASV, the HSV Walkinshaw. I don't know why it's not an HSV in Forza, but anyway. We also have the Tirana A9X and the HQ Monaro. There's a few more, though. We have the HSV VE GTS, so that's another one there, as well as the Chevrolet Supersport, which is just a rebadged Holden VF SS Commodore, so that's cool to have. And the other V8 supercars, we've got two Mercedes for some reason, so we've got the Will Davison car that's in Forza 7, as well as Ash Walsh's number 4, which I find interesting that it's in the game. And of course, the Nissan with the current spec rear wing that the Forza 7 car doesn't have, and the Volvo, a car dearly missed from Forza 7. So I thought I'd just take the Volvo out for a spin and see what it's like. And yeah, what a car. It is very, very good. It's got that, it's got the engine note that it had in real life. I mean, yeah, all the V8 supercars in Forza 6 sound like they're revving to 9,000 RPM rather than 7,000 you see in the telemetry, but the tone of the Volvo V8 supercar is there, so I'll give Turn 10 credit for that. Compared to some of the other cars, or compared to the cars of Forza 7, very stable, the Volvo. So yeah, it's a car we definitely miss. Well, as Jamie Wincup just binned it into Forest Elbow, not the first time he's bowled a race there, but anyway, the Volvo, yeah, definitely going to miss it. I'm a Holden guy, but yeah. You might be thinking, what about the DLC? Well, it reaches end of life status on September 15th. Basically, after September 15th, you won't be able to purchase the packs anymore. Anyway, I'll just show you the carbacks. We have a VIP pass as well. That carback's pretty cool, the McLaren 570S. This carpack features the Ferrari 641, Alan Prost Ferrari. The fastest car in the game, even faster than the Lotus F1 car. Bunch of Daytona prototypes, Ferrari 488 there for you. Then there's a Lycan Hypersport and a Nissan GTR Super GT car. The Koenigsegg 1-1, Ayrton Senna's McLaren from 1988. We have the Caparo as well, but which for some reason didn't make the future Forza games. We've got a Fast and Furious car back as well, so if you want to pay respects to the great Paul Walker, you can with the bright orange Super from Fast and Furious 1. And there's also a 10-year anniversary car pack, which is not available through Games with Gold this time around. In Forza 6, if you want some expansions, there's two you can buy if you want. So, with Forza 7, there's no expansions. Forza 6 has two, like you'd have in a Forza Horizon game these days. So the first expansion was the Porsche expansion. At the time, Porsche still had that exclusive rights agreement with EA, so Turn 10 were prepared to pay EA and Porsche a lot of money to get Porsches into Forza, hence the Porsche expansion. Very good expansion, I'll give Turn 10 that. It also includes the Porsche 911 GT1 race car that won Le Mans in 98. Some reason not in Forza 7, but almost all the other Porsches, well, you can use them here and there. It's really, really nice to have Porsches in Forza. And there's also another expansion. Well, this Porsche expansion has Virginia International Raceway, as I said earlier. There's also another expansion, the NASCAR expansion. This expansion gave us the rolling start, proximity arrows, and quick stops that were actually added to the base game, thanks to the NASCAR expansion. And what I think the NASCAR expansion is actually really, really cool. You have a lot of fun with these stock cars. They're actually really good fun to drive. And this expansion featured added Homestead to the game, so you know that's a good little addition as well. But a lot of the top guys' cars were here. It wasn't just three Kyle Busch cars and three Brad Keselowski cars. There was a bit of variety there, so you know you could have Dale Earnhardt's car, you could have Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s car, you could have Jimmy Johnson's car, you could have Danica Patrick's car, you could have Kevin Harvick's car, Carl Edwards, Jenny Hamlin, Jerry Logano, the list goes on and on, Brad Keselowski and Joey Logano, so you know, there was a fair bit of variety there. There were a lot of Chevrolets, but at least it wasn't just the one driver. But overall, very, very good expansion. But there, Forza 6, go get it if you haven't got it, because it is actually a very, very good game to play, even as of 2019. You know, it actually does impress me. I feel Forza 6 is a little bit more twitchy than Forza 7. That's how I feel. But overall, give this game a try, especially if you don't have the game and if you've got Xbox Gold, you may as well get it because it's free. But yeah, let me know what you think. And if you like the video, smash the thumbs up button. Leave a comment for suggestions. I will probably try multiplayer out this week and see if there's a heap of people in the lobbies. Time will tell. But if you want to see more, subscribe and tap the notification icon. Anyway, this is Jeff here and happy racing. Cheers.